So in the virtual circuit networks, we call it as VCN or virtual circuit packet switching. It is like a combination of circuit switching networks and also datagram packet switching networks. Here, before you send the data, connection should be established. We call this as a virtual connection or a logical connection, not the actual one. It's not a physical connection between the sender and the receiver. We need to establish a virtual connection. So we need to reserve the path between the sender and the receiver. We need to reserve all the resources required for data communication. And it also has a feature of datagram packet switching. That is, your data will be divided into packets. You'll not send the entire message. Your data will be divided into small, small packets. We call this process as VCNs, virtual circuit networks. Here, see, the circuit switching was implemented in the physical layer. Datagram packet switching will be implemented in the network layer. If you use this technique, virtual circuit networks, it will be implemented in the data link layer. It will be implemented in the data link layer. Here, for data communication, it uses two kinds of addresses. One is global address. You can use MAC address as a global address for data communication here because it is in the data link layer. The other one is a local address which has a limited scope. We call this address as VCI or a virtual circuit identifier. See, every switch has so many ports. I have shown this switch in the last class. Not right, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Say we have created one simple network. There exist two devices. I don't know where these two devices are exist. In between these two devices, we have so many intermediate nodes. Now, this node can act like an intermediate node between the PC0 and the other switch. This switch acts like an intermediate node between two switches. Like that, these switches may be connected to few other devices also. There may be few other devices. Even these two are connected. There exist three connection from this switch. Here, there are three connections: one towards PC0, one towards PC2, another one towards the switch 1. There exist three connections. Each connection, each link will be identified by a number called as VCI, virtual circuit identifier. Any doubt in this? Even though switch has so many ports, they may be active or not. See, this switch has four ports, 1, 2, 3, 4. This switch has four ports. Among these ports, one port is connected to PC0, another port is connected to PC2, and the third port is connected to switch 1. So all these ports are connected to some of the devices. Each connection will be identified by one address, one number called as a virtual circuit identifier. So there are two addressing mechanism used in this method. One is global addressing and the second one is virtual circuit identifier, which is a local addressing. Global addressing andre illi MAC address. It is a MAC address. Every port will be identified by one unique ID called as a MAC address. Every device will be identified. Every networking port will be identified by a unique port called as a MAC address. But we use one more address in this, that is VCI, Virtual Circuit Identifier. This is a link. The Virtual Circuit Identifier is a link between the switch port and any other device, as I showed in the Cisco packet tracer. Okay, similar to your circuit switching, here also we have three phases: setup phase, data transfer phase, and tear down phase. So we'll see the setup phase. Say A and B are the two devices. They want to communicate with each other. A and B are the two devices. They want to communicate with each other. In between A and B, there are three intermediate nodes. One is switch 1, switch 2, and the other one is switch 3. So here, every node should maintain, every switches should maintain one table like this. Incoming port number, incoming VCI. Outgoing port number, outgoing VCI. In switch 2, again incoming port number, incoming VCI. Outgoing port number, outgoing VCI. Similarly, the switch 3 will also maintain one table like this. Every switch should maintain one table like this. There will be four fields in it: incoming port number, incoming virtual circuit identifier, outgoing port number, outgoing virtual circuit identifier. What is this port number? Suppose if there are 5 ports in this switch, every port will be assigned with one number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. That is port number. What is VCI? Every device connected to a switch, that connection will be identified by some number. It can be any number, but it should be unique with respect to that switch. Aa switch connect agiro ella connection go one unique number kortivi. We'll assign one unique number to every connection. We call this as VCI, Virtual Circuit Identifier. So now, first phase is setup phase. Here, before sending the data to the B, one request will be sent from A to B. We call this as setup signal. First, the signal will go to the switch 1. Now, switch 1 will check. Oh, this message is from node A. Oh, I have received this from port number 1. The number given for this logical connection is 14. Now, what I will do, it has to be sent to B. What is his MAC ID? Oh, this is his MAC ID. I need to send this to B. So, how can I send? Okay. If I want to send this device, sorry, this message to B, I should use the port number 3. It maintains one routing table. It verifies that and forward the signal to switch 2 through the port number 3. Now switch 2 receives this. Oh, I got some message. This is from port number 1. What is the number given for this connection? Oh, it is 66. Record it. It should be sent to node B. So open the routing table. In the routing table, it has mentioned that if I want to send the data to B, I should send it to port number 2. You send it and record it. Similarly, switch 3 receives. It checks, I received a message from port number 2. What is the VCI? 22. Make a note of it. Forward it to port 3. Make a note of it. Now B receives this. A setup request is sent from node A to node B by passing through all these intermediate nodes. Now B will send an acknowledgement message in the reverse direction. B sent one acknowledgement message. Okay, I am agreed to establish a connection with you. So now switch 3 checks. Okay, I received a acknowledgement message from which identifier? 77. You make a note of it. Forward that message to switch 2. Now switch 2 will check. This is from VCI 22. Make a note of it. Switch 2 will forward it to switch 1. Switch 1 will check. This is a message from VCI 66. Make a note of this and send it to A. Now A will receive the acknowledgement.
the connection is established, a routing path is established. Now A can send any data to B by through this path. When A sends the data to B, first it goes to switch one. Switch one checks, oh, this is from port one. Immediately forward it to port three. Switch two will open it. Oh, this is from port one. Forward it to port two. This is from port two. Forward it to port three. Like that, data will be forwarded without processing much to the node A. We call this as second phase, that is data transfer phase. Once your communication is done, the teardown request will be sent from node A to node B in the same direction, and all the resources allocated for this communication will be removed. This table entry will be deleted, and now the connection is terminated. We call this as VCN, teardown phase. We'll see the delay involved in this process, similar to circuit switching and packet switching. Here it involves first delay for establishing the connection, then for data transmission, and again we have a delay for teardown. See, 3T, T stands for transmission time, similar to packet datagram packet switching, plus 3 tau. Tau stands for propagation delay, as we discussed in the last class. Then some setup delay and also teardown delay, and there may be some waiting times. So this is the delay involved in this approach. Even though it has some delay, we use this for data communication in many of the applications. Reason is, even though we need to spend some amount of time for establishing the connection and for terminating the connection, the data communication will be secured. Once the connection is established, no need to worry much. You can send the data in the proper order. You can secure this connection link. So we go with this approach in majority of the cases. The TCP protocol make use of this approach, and UDP protocol will make use of datagram packet switching. All your email, file transfer applications, HTTP web browsing application, all these things uses this VCNs, virtual circuit network, for communication. All these video charts, normal interactive charts, audio communications like WhatsApp call, it may be Zoom, whatever we are doing now, Zoom call, all these things make use of the previous approach, that is datagram packet switching. Because these applications require faster delivery than compared to reliability. That's why we face a lot of connection breaks. So these approaches uses the previous one, datagram packet switching. Your email, web browsing, all these application uses VCN, virtual circuit network.